What is happening? Is Thomas Tuchel the right man for Chelsea? United have travelled to Stamford Bridge to take on Thomas Tuchel's Chelsea in a game which was hyped up to be a good one, to kind of be a exciting game. It was. Unfortunately, the goals didn't come to what I would have expected. I thought it was going to be 2-1 Manchester United. I personally thought that with the kind of attacking oomph that United have showed, yes, they struggled a wee bit, but it's still United away from home, as ending 0-0 in a game where very fine margins, I would say, to whether or not it should have. For me personally, I think 100% that the draw, the 0-0, was annoying. 100% watching the game is just, from a neutral standpoint, you'd want goals for me to talk about on here for the time being until lockdown gets lifted is annoying, because I want goals and goals and goals to talk about, to help the videos, to kind of give my more opinion on it. But it wasn't to be with this game. It's annoying because the way that the games have went in previous times, the previous game between the two was at Old Trafford, which that was a 0-0. I don't know when the last time they both, when the both teams met in the Premier League, that was 0-0 both times. I don't know. The game, it was fine margins, as I say. I think I'm surprised that Timo Werner didn't start. I think the way that United set up was suitable to play against Chelsea, as with the Giroud, Chelsea's wingers would have been, and fullbacks would have been, told by Tuchel, ball in the box, ball in behind, give Giroud scraps, let Giroud have fights basically, let him have a physical battle with Maguire, let him test Lindelof to see if he's up for the challenge. But he done that slightly, and it wasn't enough. Giroud had a couple of chances, one about the 36th minute, I think, where he went for it and he kind of came off a bit worse. This game, I do think if Timo Werner did start, as the stats showed, United were a lot higher up on the average positioning for each individual player. I think that Werner starts in a sat deeper. I definitely think that this game probably would have been the better one to start Werner instead of Giroud. I definitely think that Tuchel, a couple of changes he didn't get right. I think he kind of set up in a 5-3-2 to kind of combat United's quick counter-attacking system. With United, the likes of, I think, Rashford had chances, Bruno had chances, Fred. Every kind of player had chances. I think it was maybe the 90th minute, roughly. Chelsea had a free kick. Reece James had a good ball in. Nobody attacked it. United countered. But unfortunately, for poor ball from Scott McTominay on the counter, Kante intercepted. I kind of stopped it for going in the box. And probably would have had United the 3 points. I would have moved them within single digits of Man City. But a draw, in the grand scheme of things, probably does seem fair. Not either one of the teams had that killer instinct, killer blow to it. On another day, you probably think that they'll both smash goals in, and they probably do. But that's the way the game goes. Chelsea, with a great chance to move into the top four under Tuchel, they remain unbeaten under him. Sanchez came in under stewardship after the departure of Frank Lampard sacking. It's definitely more positives from Tuchel. It's another game where they've failed to be beaten in, that they've probably dominated in possession but not really created too many killer chances. Same with United. Feels like all it just was like, a win would be good, but make sure we don't lose. And that's the way that you'll probably set up against Man City when they travel to there, I think, next weekend. With other games against the top six, I think that's how they're kind of set up. I think if United can pick up three or four players in the summer, that they will definitely quite chance for the league next season. But that's the way that goes. I think that the 0-0 was played lightly. Both teams, poor, but they move, everyone moves. But talking about the second game, Man City West Ham, it was definitely a good game. I think it was like this Chelsea and Manchester United game. The only difference would be is there's goals. Obviously there's goals. Man City, I think it's now 20 games unbeaten. I think that's the first goal conceded in 12 hours of football. So that's obviously quite a lot. That's what, 90? About 5 or 6 games, I think. 1.5 is 2. No. Whatever it is. I think it's hard to try and talk about these games. I think with the game, obviously, this is probably the first time in a while that I've watched both of the games, a full kind of full of the both halves. I think City, they dominated, they had plenty of chances. I think if this was West Ham of last season, they would have got scalped. But I think it was annoying because I predicted 2-0 Man City, 2-1 Man City. I think it was a close game, West Ham had chances, they did get a goal just before half time. City did win the game with it being they're both centre-backs scoring, John Stones, Ruben Dias. The first goal was a great ball in from Kevin De Bruyne, just on his weak foot, Cresswell trying to shove him down to avoid the right foot cross, De Bruyne left foot, whipped in back post, Ruben Dias pinging header across. Very, very unfortunate for Dan Randolph and goal for West Ham. And then, obviously with City, conceding just before half-time to West Ham. Quick counter, I think it was Jesse Lingard or Fornals that played the ball across. Lingard got a touch, was sent it into the back post for Antonio, for one each. West Ham failed to clear the lines from a corner. The ball was put back in from Riyad Mahrez, and it's a good finish from John Stones to make it 2-1, which Man City seen it out, which takes them to 20 consecutive wins, which if Man City win the next 5 consecutive Premier League games, they will be crowned Premier League champions. And I think that will be, with 25 consecutive wins, the most consecutive winning streak, I think, where either in the 21st century or of all time of professional football, which is nuts. The game, I think, was deserved for City, obviously. The way that Pep Guardiola's side has been playing, it definitely was the right result, I think. West Ham can hold a performance high. Unfortunately, they couldn't score more. They had chances, but they couldn't take them. But with that, I think I've talked enough. Hope you enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you have. Subscribe to the channel. I'm going to be changing up the content hopefully soon. It depends on the lockdown. Hopefully in the next few weeks to 6-7 weeks, it's out. It's football style challenges. It's eating challenges maybe. It's all types of different content, even with gaming. With that, catch you all later. Hope you enjoyed the weekend. Have a good week, as I always say. But with that, good. Bye. Peace.